This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes why managers don't necessarily investigate all variances, and primarily related to direct materials, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead. So we're really talking about a manufacturing environment and how managers choose the variances that they want to investigate. So companies do rarely investigate all variances. It can take a lot of time, it can be very inefficient, and it can be costly. So companies don't really look usually at all variances. They will tend to want to narrow it down. So criteria must be established then to determine which variances to focus on. And we call this management by exception, in that that's kind of the common term, in that managers focus solely on variances that are significant. When they do that, they're really managing by exception. If they look at all variances, then that's not the case. But we're really describing a situation where they're following the management by exception rule. So let's get into talking about how managers do determine which variances to investigate. And remember that we have for direct materials, this isn't a separate, these are separate videos. In direct materials, there are two variances. In direct labor, there are two variances as well. And the same goes for variable manufacturing overhead. So what we're getting at here is what criteria do managers often use to investigate certain variances? It might be that they're going to investigate all variances above a certain dollar amount. It may be that some companies will investigate the variances that are above a certain percentage of the flexible budget. It may be that companies will combine the two, and they'll look at variances that are above a certain dollar amount and above a certain percentage. There are definitely other ways to do this as well. This is just to give you an idea of what managers might do to figure out which variances to investigate. There are three separate sets of videos that I've created related to direct materials, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead. So you'll need to see those separate videos to see where these numbers come from. But this is basically a summary of all of those variances from those different videos, and the numbers do match. So if you want to go back and take a look at those, you'll see how those numbers tie into this. So once we have the variances, what we're trying to do here is to figure out which ones to take a closer look at and try to figure out why these variances occurred. So this is just simply laying out all of the variances, and you'll see here, just to point out a few of these, that we had an $88,000 unfavorable direct materials price variance. We had a $21,000 favorable direct materials quantity variance. Remember that favorable variances are shown in brackets, and unfavorable variances are shown as positive numbers, particularly when they relate to cost variances, and that's exactly what we're looking at here. And so you can see all of the variances are here. Those are the first two, but you can also see the direct labor variances and the variable overhead variances. And we'll come back to this and take a look at which of these we want to investigate. So here's this scenario. Our company is Jerry's Ice Cream, and this is the company we produce ice cream, and this is the company that we've been using throughout this chapter and throughout the videos that relate to direct materials, direct labor, and variable manufacturing overhead. We're going to assume here, in the first bullet point, that management has a policy that we will investigate all variances, I should say, that are at or above 10% of the flexible budget amount for each cost. So that's going to require going back, looking at the flexible budget, and then determining from that flexible budget, and these are in previous videos and separate videos, from that flexible budget, which variances, what those dollar amounts are, and 10% of that then will determine if it's over that or equal to that, which variances we're going to take a look at. And so in the second bullet point here, I've done that work for you, and it turns out that we are going to investigate all variances for direct materials. We're going to investigate all variances at or above $42,000. So if you want to go back to the previous slide, you'll be able to see what our direct materials variances were, and you can identify, well, which ones were above $42,000. And by the way, that's either favorable or unfavorable, doesn't matter. And we're going to take a look at that, and you can see the calculation here. It's 10% times the flexible budget of $420,000. And again, that's in a separate video where you can find that related to direct materials. Then for direct labor, we took 10% of the flexible budget of $273,000, and that means that we're going to look at any variances that are at or above $27,300 for direct labor. And we also have For variable overhead, 10% of the flexible budget of $105,000, which tells us we're going to look at all variances that are at or above $10,500 for our variable manufacturing overhead variances. If you want to go back to the previous slide, you can take a look at the variances that are there, but I actually summarize them below. So you can see that based on this policy, here's the information here, based on this information and the policy that management has put into place, we're going to take a look at four different variances. Again, you can go back to the previous slide if you want to see where this comes from. But we have an unfavorable direct materials variance that is $88,000, and that is above our criteria of $42,000 from up above. Remember this $42,000 up here? So that's above the $42,000, and we're going to go ahead and take a look at that then and find out why we have that price variance. And that means we're going to get out there and talk to, at a minimum, our purchasing agents within the company to find out why we had that price variance. And they may have a legitimate reason why, we just need to find out what caused that. We also have an unfavorable direct labor rate variance of $37,800, and that is above the threshold of $27,300 that we calculated up above. It's $27,300 up here, and so we're going to go ahead and take a look at that variance. We had a direct labor, and find out why the direct labor rate variance, why the rates were higher than we anticipated. We had a favorable direct labor efficiency variance that is above, actually it's right at our criteria of $27,300. So we're going to take a look at that as well and find out why did our direct labor workforce work more quickly? Why were they more efficient than we had anticipated? Maybe we put a training program in place and it worked out really well for us, but we want to find out why that happened. And we'll talk to our production personnel to see if we can get some more information on that. And then lastly, we had the variable efficiency variance of $10,500, which is right at the minimum $10,500. So we're going to investigate that as well. So again, this is one approach to how to determine which variances to investigate. There are many different ways to do this, but typically companies will set some type of criteria so that they're not looking at all variances because that can become very costly.